Hello guys, Zoljan here. Welcome to another episode of No Man's Sky. I hope you guys are having an awesome day today. Thanks so much for the amazing support on the No Man's Sky series, guys. As always, if you do enjoy the videos, give me some dap on that like button to show your support. And you can subscribe to the channel for more daily videos. So, last time we left off, there was a distress beacon that we were following. And it looked like it was pretty much out of reach, like the time kept resetting. For some reason, when I got back in my ship, I was able to get a lot closer to it. But, using my ship to kind of explore around, I stopped at quite a bit of points of interest. And I did come across something really cool. Remember that bypass chip that we could have accessed something with? Well, I actually used one of those things, and it took me to this spot right here. Let me see if I can go ahead and get out of my ship. And this is supposedly an alien artifact of some sort. So let's see where it was. There it is. It's this little purple icon here. Hold on. Let me make my way around here. I've just been scanning stuff and kind of exploring. There it is down there. And it looks like the sentinels are kind of checking it out too. Alright, so this is going to be a little tough to get into. I would bring my ship down there, but I don't think that's really, really necessary. The question is, will I be able to get back up? It looks like the other side is less steep than this side. So I'll tell you what, I'm going to go ahead and go for it here. Try to just go on top. Destination reached. Alright, very good. And what is this thing? Ruins of Turfindra? What? An ancient marker hums at the frequency that burrows deep into my being, filling me with voices of Korvac's echoes. Knowledge paves the way to the understanding of probability. The Atlas spoke in fragments. The Atlas interfaces are their shadows. The monoliths are their scattered children. Together they convey wisdom of the infinite. They must be understood. Seek help with language. That's my only option, it looks like. My knowledge of the Korvac's convergence increases. You have learned Korvac's word of probability. The Korvac's standing has increased. Alright, that's pretty cool. Also, there was a couple things that I accessed that gave me some suit upgrades, and I'm going to show that to you in just a second here. Alright, so we got... Oh, learned 8 words! So... I guess learning Korvac is a big part of the game. You know, one of my favorite games of all time, Final Fantasy X, had a language that you can start to understand called Albed, and you had to keep on finding tomes hidden around the world. Okay, so let's see if we can actually go back here. I'm guessing this is going to be too steep. Let's go back the way that I thought I could go, which is the least steep way, probably right here. Alright, I don't just slide back down. It looks like I can pretty much scale it. Yeah, that wasn't hard at all. Alright, so my suit upgrades, you see how I have a couple of spot upgrades? They just unlocked when I found these little canisters. It almost looked like space pods. And I went up to it and it gave me the ability to upgrade my suit once for free. And then I found another one and it cost me 10,000 credits. Other than that, I just found some a few different things. I found this Tyramin. Which is a neutral metal alloy. I got this fascination bead, which is a trade commodity, a geck charm. So I've been just kind of exploring around and doing what I can. And I'll show you guys how I'm exploring on the way to get that that last beacon. Let's see. So the beacon is right there. Where is my ship? There it is. All right. I don't think there's anything that I really needed here. Alright, so I've been using my ship to kind of just blast off like this, going really, really slow and just scanning the landscape here. I do have my my stuff inverted now, because it just seems a little bit more natural to hold up while I'm going forward. Alright, so the beacon. What is that? So that looks like one of those pods that I was at before that has the upgrade. I'm gonna go ahead and stop here and show you guys what it looks like. Oh, and there's one of those things. Oh, well that's no good. All right, suit up, baby. Boatcaster. I wanna call it a boatcaster, like, There we go. Are you just gonna stay there and take it? Apparently so. Alright, no problem with that guy. Alright, let me just check him again just to make sure there's something, anything I can harvest here. I knew you were a bad guy though. No, still nothing I can do with that. Alright, okay, so let's go to this place right here. Now, these things look pretty much just alike. You see how that a little hologram comes up? And you can check it out, it says suit upgrade, interact. So I hold square. And it looks like it just added it, it didn't cost anything. Oh, purchase. Okay, so the first one may have cost me something, but I didn't see. The last one cost me 10,000, this one's gonna cost me 20,000, and I do not have enough here, which kinda sucks. But that's really, really good that you can get these slots in because they can make room for your upgrades and stuff, which is really, really cool. Let's go see what this is. Another thing that I noticed is, check this out. When I go to, actually, let's see. So it says, my waypoints have discovered are just like this. There's a couple of waypoints to discover, but the records that I can find will give me completion, and if I upload it, I can receive 275,000 credits. And these are all the discoveries that I've found so far. So these records, I can't really select them, and it doesn't really tell me what they are, but I'm gonna have to pay attention to it because I think these might be the outposts or whatever that I've been visiting. So let's see here. There's a couple things to loot. We'll go ahead and check it out. All right, my inventory is full. That's no problem. Let's see. Exosuit, starship. I do need some extra spots for the starship. I mean, really, really bad. Or an upgrade altogether. What I could do is probably just dump my nickel. The total value is 5,800, and everything that I have on me right here is pretty darn expensive, to tell you the truth. Actually, you know what? Let me just use my carbon actually, let's use the shielding shard. And I'm gonna try to use my carbon here. There we go. And that's gonna open up a couple slots for me. Alright, so let's interact with this. And we got another Gekchorm, which we can sell. Also, what are these? Inventory full. Isotope inventory full. And this is the save Plains of Nimitant. And let's see if this gives us a discovery. Alright, so are the Plains of Nimitant actually on here? No, they aren't. So that may be something else. I'm really not sure then. Alright, I really want to go check out what that is though. That looks like a whole thing with other ships docked at it and stuff. I want to bring my ship over there though, for sure. Want to bring my ship over there. Also, this little canister. What is this? A damaged machinery. New technology, phase beam. Spacefaring beam weapon, an asteroid mining tool. It's advised that isotope elements are required to recharge the device. So, you can build this because it's better for mining. That's interesting. I don't have to build it now, so I'm gonna go ahead and choose not to. It's basically like a blueprint I just got, which is really neat. Hey buddy, you wanna come on the ship with me? I don't think it's gonna give me the option to interact with him. No, maybe not. Alright, let's see here. Alright. Oh, not enough fuel in the launch for the thruster. Okay, let's see here. We can charge it up with plutonium. We are going to have to find some plutonium really soon. When I find some, I'll have to stop and do it. Alright, so plutonium, I believe on this planet, looks like yellow crystals. That's something right there. I don't know what that is, but let's see what this is. Alright. Oh, and by the way, I saw your comments, guys, on the Atlas, the Atlas marker that I missed on the first planet. I might revisit that. I think somebody said it's part of the story, but Okay, waypoint interact. Let's go ahead and waypoint interact with that. So we definitely needed that. It looks like it. That's a really cool animation when you find a waypoint, though. And I guess we can teleport. Advanced life form detected. Arrive in shelter. That's pretty neat. Okay. That's really, really cool, actually. Okay, so what else can we get here? That's to interact to restore our health. Cargo drop. Alright, let's see if we can transfer something here. It looks like I have... Oh, my starship inventory I don't have. Okay, let's check out this. Let's put up the titanium. There we go. And now we can actually check this out. Grogaf. I think we had one of those already. So it's probably no big deal. Alright, so I don't know what that life form is. But I do want to check it out. It seems really, really cool. Alright, where's my ship at again? There it is. Can I just scale up like I did last time? Looks like it. Nice. What was that sound? That's some crazy noises coming. Also, I've been thinking about those flying guys, and I really don't want to kill them. But I can probably scan one once it's dead and it falls down, so that might be a thing. Okay, can I... No, not enough fuel, man. Alright, I need to find some plutonium. I don't think I have any right now. Let's see. No, I don't. Dang it, man. Alright, I'm gonna definitely need to find some plutonium now. Let's see. So, I didn't see any yellow crystals here and there, but... Okay, there's zinc. I don't need zinc right now. I don't see any of those yellow crystals anywhere. Nowheres. What is that sound? Is there another one of those, Oh. Am I being scanned from up top? No. I have no idea. It sounds like there's a drone hovering around me, but I don't see it. Maybe it's cloaked. Oh, there it is. There it is. Alright. That had to be the noise, I guess. You never know, man. All this is a big mystery. A big old mystery. Okay, how can I find plutonium here? That's all iron. There's a weird looking kind of rock formation over there. I do think that plutonium just comes in that those yellow crystals on this planet, but I could be wrong. Also, let me just check these. Yeah, that's just iron. Also, I went in the water and scanned a bunch of stuff. The water mechanics are about how you would think they would be. So nothing too major there. See that? You just go in and out the water. You can swim when it's deep enough. Naturally, that wasn't real deep, but... Alright. So we're looking for plutonium. Alright, guys. I got enough of plutonium for one charge. And I really want to see what's up with this shelter that just showed up. Looks like there's quite a little bit here going on. And a little place across the way, too. So let's go ahead and land. And we're probably going to need some more plutonium as well, but I want to see what this is all about. This place looks really, really cool. Okay, so that's the actual icon for the beacon. Let's see what this is. Destination reached. Very cool. Zaramu Valley, I guess you could pronounce it like that. Okay. Bug would drop. What did it take? Fascination bead, another one. Okay, jettison for isotope. I don't know if that's gonna be... The only thing I'm really interested in right now is plutonium, so I do need to probably let something go. This fascination bead... I don't know, man. I mean, I don't know what I read. Iron is so common that I could probably get rid of iron. Total value is 1801 in units. We're gonna probably just get rid of that, honestly. Alright, let's see what we got. Oh, was that in my ship's inventory? Yeah, it sure was. I can transfer that, though. Let's send that fascination bead back and see what this is, huh? Power canisters. Okay, that's actually not that great. I mean, yeah, they're alright, but like, my life support system I can, for instance, power it up. So that's pretty cool. As far as plutonium goes, that was not it. Alright, let's see what else we got here. The plutonium comes in either yellow or red crystals, by the way, on this planet. Okay. Let's just go up top here. Probably the easiest way to do it. Let's go inside and see what we have. Hello? Yeah? This is your house? Let's see what he's got. Shield at maximum. Okay, that raises our shields. What about you, scientist, entity Hatura? I know a little bit of language now, like 8 words. Corvax, he said. Vinku. I don't know what that means. Walk away, uncommon isotope, thallium. Give common isotope, carbon. Hmm. The lifeform looks to me for help, and then points to my gathered resources with a single slow and desperate movement. So, he needs some help of something. Let's see. How about, can we give... I don't have either of these. Enough of it. He needs some carbon, or... I do have thallium, though. Hold on. Hold on a second here. Let's see here. Thallium. I have titanium. No, it doesn't look like I have any I do have thallium. I have... That's thallium 9. Let me go ahead and transfer this to us. Did it bring any of it? Oh, I suppose that these, I guess the amount that you can carry is bigger? Yeah. So thallium 9. Okay, let's interact with them again. Oh, now I need to send something back? You gotta be kidding me. Carbon. Let's go ahead and just discard that. Alright. So, I think I can give you what you need now, buddy. Let's see what you can take. Give uncommon isotope 50 thallium. Entity slowly inserts the element into a slot on his hip. It fully reawakens. New technology discovered. Cannon damage sigma. Photon cannon fires at an increased rate, operates automatically once constructed within the starship's inventory. That's actually pretty cool. So when you help these guys out, they can trade and give you tech and stuff, which is very interesting. What is this? Whoa. What? So it has it's a new multi-tool. It's got 8 slots instead of just 6. Oh my lord. Okay, and it's got, there's a bunch of different, it looks like it's got a bunch of upgrades already. So, compare, current, 53,325 units. That's how much it cost? Except to complete the transfer. Ah, that's to purchase it. Holy cow, man. That thing is a lot nicer, but I need cash. I really wish he would, let me just see what it says when I try to accept. Yeah, I can't. It doesn't let me. I only have 15K. I want to buy it so bad. Oh, man. Well, this is definitely very, very cool. I really, really wish that he would buy stuff from me. But, I mean, we may have other people that's in here. It would be cool if we did. Let's see. Met two aliens. Locked door. Atlas Pass V2 required. So the Atlas Passes, I believe you have to find at like space stations or whatever. I think that's what I've heard. So it should be pretty interesting here. So what else is here exactly? It's probably not much more. There was a little spot on the other side though, wasn't there? Like over that way? Let's go back to my ship. I'm probably not gonna be able to launch without a little bit more fuel. Let's see here. I don't see. Oh, look. All right, so you see that little beacon in the distance? I'll show you guys what that is. That was one of those things that I think that's one of the things that I can use a bypass chip on. Also, what do I get from this? Platinum. I might as well get it. I can always toss it if I don't want it. A little bit rare. Not super rare, but okay. Didn't I see that? Oh, there it is. It's on the other side of that. Hoping to run across some plutonium while I'm running around here would be very nice. Alright. Oh, here it is. Okay, cargo drop. It's an oxide. So, nothing found. Carbon isotope. And bypass chip required. Okay, so we can make a bypass chip here. Let's go ahead and just use... We're in the exosuit. Let's go ahead and craft. And bypass chip requires what? We need plutonium and iron. Okay, so we can't actually do that because I don't want to use any plutonium right now. Well. And I don't even see any plutonium around here, honestly. I think I'm just going to have to look around a little bit more. Alright, you guys. I got enough plutonium to charge up my ship. And now it's time to get to the distress beacon and see what's going on. I'm going to try to bypass a bunch of this stuff. I can always get some of this off camera, but I really want to show you guys what this is. I don't know what it is. I mean, I want to see it too. Don't get me wrong. I do have some selfish reasons. It's so loud, man. I lowered the volume too. 4, 3, 2, 1. Alright. Hold up. Alright. Let's look for the beacon. Where is it? It looks like it's right down here. Alright. That's where the distress is from. Alright. Let's initiate landing sequence. Very cool. Okay. Let's see what this beacon. We don't even know if it's a distress beacon. It's just something that kind of popped up while we were flying around. So we're gonna see what this is. Activate signal. Activate beacon. Hold square to interact. Okay, here we go. All right, this is the second one. Incoming signal detected. Okay. Huh. I don't understand. Okay, it did give me an outpost. Radio signal detected. Find source of life signs. Okay, so I'm guessing we have to go to that outpost now. Alright, let's get... I wonder if that's the same outpost that I saw just a second ago. Huh, it's hard to tell. That sounded like a gun cocked, huh? Wow, that's kind of scary there, game. All right, I threw some of the, that platinum away because it's a little bit more common to find than I thought. And don't let the name platinum fool you. It's not worth that much. All right, let's go ahead and take off here. Okay, so let's go. It's kind of like a quest that we got now, right? So let's go to where it says I need to go, which is like there. Okay, we could speed it up a little bit. I don't know if this is the same outpost we were at. It might be another one. I would kill for a merchant right about now. I would kill. Okay. Let's go ahead and land. I think I went too far. A while ago, I landed so close to a rock that I actually crashed into it and did a lot of damage to my ship and stuff. So that's something I want to avoid, naturally. Okay, it looks like it's just over the hill right here. Not bad. Day Nalal Badlands? Okay. Oh yeah, this does look different. Oh, look at all the little animals. Hey, little baby! It's a little baby! Oh, look all the plutonium too. Nice. Very nice. Okay, let's see what this is all about. That's the window. Let's see if we can actually go through the door. And this is the guy. Okay. Chemist entity? Oh, come on. Always inventory full. Okay. I don't want to do, let's go ahead and discard the thaumium. If he wants the thaumium, I'm going to be so mad. It's only 3 units. That's all right. Oh, was that the ship? Oh, I can send it to the ship though. All right, let's go ahead and send the plutonium to the ship. I could have stacked that stuff too. I didn't even think about it. Okay. What do you have to say, chemist? Traveler. So it's like he's addressing me. I cannot discern if the entity is flesh, machine, or both. Lights flicker across its visor, but it's motionless. This is the head nods mechanically just once towards a slate nearby. With a start, I realize that I can understand the text on it. I look to the entity for answers, but it remains still and silent. I suspect it's a mere courier, not the author of this message. The slate also contains a blueprint for a new technology, a hyperdrive? Take the blueprint? Instructions on how to traverse the stars. This will be invaluable. Calm blue lights dart across the being's mask as it's transmitting something. Okay, I got the hyperdrive, light speed warp drive. So I need a dynamic resonator and a bunch of heridium, which I already have some heridium. Dynamic resonator. Looks like I could craft that in my inventory slots. So let's see here. That's not what I wanted to do. Craft dynamic resonator. I don't think I have. I mean, I don't have a dynamic resonator to craft that. I really don't. I don't know what that's all about then. All right, let's see the couple other things here. Interact with Galactic Trade Terminal. Don't tell me. I can sell items right here. Oh, baby. Sell items from your inventories. Okay, we're definitely selling all of this stuff here. Let's see. Can I just... Oh, baby. Oh, that's awesome. I'm selling a bunch of this stuff. Neutrino module. It's a trade command. A valuable computer part. A much favored trading item. Okay. I can't sell these shielding shards or nothing. You can sell all of the materials. But I don't know if I'm going to need these for anything here. I could sell plutonium as well. Suspension fluid. The thaumium. Okay. That's all they buy, I believe. I'll tell you what. Let me get out of this menu and see if I can trade anything from my starship here. Uh-huh. Let me bring all of this to me. Oh, starship's out of range. You gotta be kidding me. How close do you have to be? I'm gonna have to go back and forth and sell all this stuff. Okay, what else is in here? I'm gonna do that after the fact. There's another weapon terminal. Okay, this one, I don't know if this one is as good. 52,650 credits. It's got a beam intensifier too. I think the other one was actually better, but I don't know. No, the other one was 8 slots, I believe. I do have enough credits for it. Man, you know, I think I want to take it, you guys. I think I'm going to take it. Yep. Let's compare. So it's 5 slots versus 8 slots. It has a rapid fire, a range boost, and an intensifier increase. So the only thing it doesn't have is a focus sigma, which I can probably take that off of it, or I can build another one on it. Let's go ahead and complete the transfer. Actually, you know what? Hold on. Let me check my weapon first. My multi-tool. And see if I can remove this. Dismantle would be... Yeah, let's go ahead and dismantle this. It's going to give us some plutonium too. Okay, so if we're going to trade this in, we might as well trade. You know what I mean? Okay. Alright. Compare. Accept the transfer. So we got a new weapon. All right, now we have this bad boy. Okay, so install technology. So we can actually put our, we can actually build a beam intensifier on this one. We already have one at 2. What does it do here? Aha, okay, so you can actually, yeah, that's actually really, really cool. Man, okay, we got a nice upgrade. That really is neat. Okay, so acquire hyperdrive, build hyperdrive, and fuel hyperdrive are the next things that I have to do. Building a hyperdrive is going to need a special deal. New business earned 51,847. I guess that's, oh, that's an achievement. Yeah, okay. Sweet. What else you got in here, my man? I don't think there's going to be a whole lot that I can access. Okay, that's outside, and there's a ship out there, too. That's interesting. This is nothing? Oh, this trade terminal, though, was awesome. Okay. Alright, let's go outside and... Oh, nice. An orbital station coordinates? Okay. Let's see what this... What's this all about? Interact... Scholar entity. Something about Traveler. Make an offer for the lifeform starship. Sell items to the... Oh, they had 2. What does he sell, actually? Let's see really quickly. Power canisters, power gear, shield plating, shield swords, kerite sheets, unstable plasma, suspension fluid. He sells plutonium. He sells fuel. That's pretty cool. Does he sell any one of those nice things that I need for the hyperdrive? It doesn't look like... Oh, a dynamic resonator. He does. Buy it. Ha ha! Ha ha! So I'll be able to build it. The dynamic resonator is what I needed. Okay. And make an offer for the lifeform starship. What exactly? 213,000 units, but look at all the slots. It's a 17-slot ship. Very, very nice. I'm gonna have to definitely look into that. Well, guys, that's all the time I think we have for this episode. I hope y'all enjoyed it. If you did, give me some dap on that like button to show your support, and you can subscribe to the channel for more daily videos, guys. Thanks so much for watching. As always, this is Uldian signing off, and we'll see you next time.